and this next comment gets straight to the point, sounds crap. So Nvidia yesterday announced an RTX 3080 tier to their GeForce Now gaming experience, which is basically a cloud service. I did a video yesterday and the comments were really overwhelming. People do not want this service. Let's talk about the reactions of everybody that saw that video. Remember to check out today's sponsor, cdkdeals.com. Yes, these keys are even going to work in Windows 11 whenever you upgrade to that. Very simple process. If you use my code CC20, you're going to get a nice discount at checkout, and it's going to get rid of that annoying Windows watermark when it's not activated. So check out CDK Deals for your CD key needs, and remember, it will work with Windows 11. Now back to the video. Hey guys, Tiago with Classical Technology here. Remember to subscribe and smash that like button. We cover GPUs as well as other PC hardware, CPUs, water cooling, basically everything to do with computers. So let's talk about, it's kind of like a little reaction video to yesterday. Nvidia just announced the RTX 3080 tier to their cloud gaming service, the GeForce Now experience. Now, previously they had what they called a priority experience. This basically allows you to use a cloud service if you don't have a powerful GPU in order to be able to play like your Steam game library or something like that. Works with other ones as well, like Epic Games. The general idea behind this is if you can't get a GPU, let's say if you're stuck on something that's really old and outdated and you don't have a powerful computer, you would use a cloud service like this in order to be able to harness the power of what now is a 3080 to be able to play newer games with ray tracing. It goes up to 4K if you have an Nvidia Shield, or it can even go up to, if you have a regular PC, around 1440p, 120 frames per second. Now, the big kicker here is you're also going to need a pretty fast internet connection. Latency is a huge issue for these type of cloud streaming services, so that's going to be a pretty big red flag right there. If you don't have a very fast and stable internet connection, you're definitely going to have trouble playing these games. It's going to be laggy. It's going to be really give you all types of trouble. So certainly there are some technical limitations to this. I mean, obviously everybody would rather have a real RTX 3080, but with this massive, GPU shortage, this was, I guess, thrown out as an idea from Nvidia. Probably they could get people that couldn't get a GPU to at least try the service and see what they would think. And now the other issue here is it's not exactly cheap. It ends up being around $200 for a full year. Right now it seems like the price is $99 for 6 months. Previously their priority tier was about $49.99 for 6 months. At the end of the day, a lot of people just feel like they're almost just renting a GPU for the privilege to be able to play some games. And of course, nowhere near really the full capacity, regardless of how powerful these GPUs are, because after all, you're going to be dealing with the internet and latency, and that really is a huge issue. So I'm going to read through a lot of the comments from the video yesterday, and you'll see that a lot of people basically felt pretty much the same way. It really wasn't, well, we had people on one side with one argument and people on another side with a different argument. At least at face value, most people pretty much did not like this idea. We're going to see what people specifically said. So at least on the onset, before this thing is actually released as the 3080 tier, we know sort of what the experience is like on the priority tier. I actually have it running in the background here, Shadow of the Tomb Raider, played through my Steam library with the GeForce Now priority level. The 3080 tier is supposed to be coming out sometime in November and December. And then of course you do have to remember you have various other drawbacks. Like for example, you're going to be limited to your session hours. In the priority case, it's around 6, and the new 3080 tier, it's going to be around 8 hours. So I'm assuming that's going to be 8 hours in a 24-hour day. So if you do plan to game more than that, it's not really going to work for you. And of course, if you play competitive games that really depend on fast reaction times and low latency, like FPS games, maybe even some RTS games, this certainly is not going to work well for you. I could see this working for, maybe a casual gamer that just wants a nice graphical experience, or maybe somebody that just wants to play in a nice big open world, maybe even single player games where if you get a little lag, a little micro lag, it's not really going to be the end of the world. But definitely for competitive gaming, you want to kind of stay away from this. So now let's start to read some of the comments, and I think you guys will agree with me. Most of them definitely do not want this service, at least how it's presented. So Nvidia's either going to have to provide tremendous value, maybe like Xbox Game Pass, where they get a lot of free games every month, in order to be able to make it feel like at least you're paying for something you can keep and not something that you merely are renting and then you really don't own anything. That seemed to be a lot of people's criticisms as well. it's certainly very, very justified. You know, nobody really wants more subscription services. It seems like everything is kind of going that path, including games, and now it seems like hardware is even being thrown into that subscription model. So let's take a look at some of these comments and see what people really think about this possible service. All right, so these two comments here were back to back. Here, Tycondero said, no solution. Sorry, we just want cheaper hardware. Now, certainly the confusion between hardware and software as a service, or not confusion, I would say, you know, blurring of the lines between software and hardware as a service. I think most people have to accept that software as a service, you know, content as a service is pretty much here to stay. Everything from Netflix to even things like we mentioned, Game Pass, and, you know, PlayStation has these type of services where you pay a certain fee every month and you're allowed to, you know, download certain games and, you know, stream other games. So software and content, you know, media as a service is definitely, unfortunately, here to stay. Now, hardware as a service, which this 3080 tier and even the priority tier, that's essentially what it is. You don't have the hardware to run games at a certain spec, so you basically pay a subscription fee to be able to have access to that remote server that's then going to be able to display to the best of the ability of your internet and that service capabilities, that game on your screen better than perhaps what you have in your computer now would do. Now, while on the surface, the idea seems good, you know, you'll be able to have much better performance as the end result on your screen. But if you really analyze it, people are feeling like they're getting pretty much hardware taken out from under their feet, and then it's being substituted by basically what is a rental, you know, the subscription fee of what should be hardware, and you should be able to own and do with as you wish in your own system. Now, this comment also mentions that they want cheaper hardware, and that makes complete sense with everything that's been going on now. We've talked about at length on this channel how GPU pricing is really getting considerably out of control. It's very, very expensive. That's why a service like this likely will sneak in, and I'm sure users will take advantage of it. We just have to see if at the end of the day, are you really just renting the hardware? Nvidia is going to have to provide a tremendous amount of value for this to even make sense. As it stands now, to play your own library and rent this for, you know, $200 a year, many people don't like that. I think many people would just rather buy a $200 or $300 GPU, keep it in their system. At least they have that resale value. That's going to be a big thing here. People just want to own the hardware that they're really given. So this either is a very niche little service for occasional users, but I'm not too sure if the way that it's branded now, it's really going to appeal to an audience that wants hardware. That's really the primary problem here. Now, I would say even at those prices, the comparison isn't very favorable still to this type of service, because even if you do have to pay to upgrade your GPU every 2 years, you still have the value of the GPU that you can resell, especially in today's market conditions. Often you can get even more for a GPU that you bought at MSRP. So this argument, I'm not too sure it's going to fly. At the end of the day, if you're paying money to rent or have a subscription service on the 3080, basically you're not getting anything back for that money at the end of, you know, at the end of that payment, as opposed to having a GPU, unless Nvidia provided more value to the service. That's what I want to stress. Aside from just having access to an RTX 3080 that you rent, they also want to know that there's other money value added things to it, be it in free games or discounts on games, much like the other sort of subscription services have been functioning thus far. And they also want the choice to still be able to use a real GPU, which I think, of course, will always be there, even though the market conditions are absolutely terrible. Unless things really change, like Blockbuster and Video changed, you know, with Netflix and subscription services are now, I don't think PC hardware is going to go away. And then, of course, the comments continue. The majority of them are really against this idea. This user, Chardabona, even says it's just mining in reverse. Instead of getting paid $200 a month to rent out your 3080, when you're not using it, you're paying somebody $200 a year to borrow, you know, their 3080, which is kind of true. You're basically paying to borrow a 3080. You're paying Nvidia a subscription. So it's almost like they're kind of mining your gaming capabilities with that GPU. In a way, it is mining in reverse. Not exactly, but, you know, it kind of is. And this next comment gets straight to the point. Sounds crap. And then Gaming Bad, he brings up a good point. What if somebody blocks your GeForce Now account? Not only are you out of sort of the streaming service, but also supposedly you don't have have any hardware now to play any games. So if something happens, if you lose your password or something like that, all of a sudden you pretty much have no access to this RTX 3080 or whatever tier that you're playing on. So that's very true. That's almost like if you have all your games in the game library like Steam, forget your password. What are you going to do if you can't recover it? It's not a physical disk you can keep in your with your possessions. Now, this is certainly very valid, and it makes people feel like they're just outright not owning anything at all, which you'll see is really the continuing trend in all of these comments. Here's a comment from somebody who has used the service. This is going to be from Everett. He said he gave it a shot and didn't care for it. The lag made the game rubber band all over the place at certain points. Now, this is certainly going to be the biggest issue. That's going to be the latency. Aside from the fact if it's a good value or not, if you're renting a GPU, that's one discussion. The next discussion is, does it actually work? If Nvidia, you know, could actually make a system that it would be really, really low latency, as they say it is, maybe in the real world we would have to see what people's experiences are. If that was very consistent, low latency, if the graphics could be high refresh rate, ray tracing, it looked really great, then at least the end product is not that bad for the people that do want to use it. Now, then value for the money becomes a whole different discussion, but it's an easier discussion if the end product is good. If it sucks and it's full of lag and it's just overpriced, then people simply won't use it, and most likely it will sort of go away with time, and even the value proposition is not going to matter just because it's not going to be something that's sticking around. If it is really good, however, that's when sort of the discussions on the value, the price to performance can enter the fray, because then it's something that might make sense for people to use. Or else I could see this as not really being a very good price to performance alternative. If you can't get a GPU, it might just be better to get a console or get a much cheaper older GPU until things get a little better and you can actually game the way that you want. All right, guys, so remember to subscribe, smash that like button, and I'll see you guys on the next video.